We're here to witness the work of the railway. A railway connection reflects many of the aspects of the European Union integration. It's about movement, free movement of goods, services, capital, but of course, free movement of people. And in other words, the four freedoms that are the foundation of the European Union, which Serbia aspired to join. A railway symbolizes strength, integration, unity, and common standards.
Poštovani predsjedniče Vučiću, cenjeni ministri Vesić i Miščević, dragi kolege, predstavnici medija, dragi prijatelji. Danas smo ovde da obiđemo radove na modernizaciji železničke veze koja pokazuje brojne aspekte evropske integracije. Predstavlja i slobodu kretanja roba, usluga, ali takođe kapitala i naravno pre svega ljudi. Drugim rečima, simbol je četiri slobode na kojima se zasniva Evropska unija kojoj Srbija teži da se pridruži. Železnica je simbol snage, integracija, jedinstva i zajedničkih standarda.
So this railway contributes to connecting Serbia to the European Union and to bring Serbia closer to the European Union, connecting Niš with the Dimitrovgrad and further down east to Sofia and further to the east is an important step. We will be modernizing the railways, make it safer and contribute to the regional economic development and increase competitiveness of this beautiful part of Serbia, Southeast Serbia, where we are today.
U tom smislu, ovaj železnički projekat će doprineti daljem napretku Srbije na njenom putu ka članstvu u Evropskoj uniji, bolje povezavši Niš sa Dimitrovgradom, ali i dalje ka Sofiji i istoku, kroz modernizovanu i bezbednu železnicu koja će doprineti daljem regionalnom razvoju i takođe povećati konkurentnost ovog divnog dela Srbije, jugoistočnog dela Srbije.
And this project we're visiting today is the component one of the overall project to modernize the railway infrastructure on the Sičevo to Dimitrovgrad railway section, but it's only the beginning. And looking ahead, the EU is proud to work with Serbia and supporting the construction of the railway bypass around the city of Niš, which would mainly serve for improving the freight railway connection between Niš and Dimitrovgrad and further to Sofia, but also to significantly facilitate the urban transport within the city of Niš, therefore benefiting directly to the safety of the citizens. The EU is funding this project with a grant of 108.6 million euros and the European Investment Bank is providing 134 million of soft loans, altogether 242 million from the European Union for this project.
Danas smo na ovom gradilištu koji predstavlja prvu komponentu celokupnog projekta koji se odnosi na modernizaciju železničke infrastrukture na deonici Sićevo-Dimitrovgrad. I to je samo početak. Gledajući napred, Evropska unija sa ponosom radi zajedno sa Republikom Srbijom da na podršci izgradnji železničke obilaznice oko Niša, što će prevashodno služiti unapređenju teretnog železničkog saobraćaja i železničke veze između Niša i Dimitrovgrada i dalje ka Sofiji. Paralelno sa tim, to će biti i značajno olakšanje za sam gradski saobraćaj unutar samog grada Niša, što će ići direktno u korist građanima Srbije. Za ovaj projekat Evropska unija je obezbedila 108,6 miliona evra granta, odnosno bespovratne pomoći. Evropska investiciona banka je obezbedila povoljan zajem u vrednosti od 134 miliona evra. Što znači sve ukupno za ovaj projekat Evropska unija je obezbedila iznos od 242 miliona evra.
So this line will be electrified and equipped with modern European rail traffic management system, which will make it safer and interoperable railway line in line with the EU standards. And we know that transport infrastructures, including railways, is essential for economic growth. And the southeast of Serbia has already attracted important investment from European Union-based company, such as Michelin, a world-leading manufacturer of tires that acquired the Tiger Tires factory in Pirot, making the sixth biggest exporter from Serbia in 2023 with 454.9 million euros.
Ova linija će biti elektrifikovana i opremljena najsavremenijim sistemom, evropskim sistemom za upravljanje železničkim saobraćajem. To će obezbediti bezbedniju i interoperabilniju železničku liniju u skladu sa najvišim evropskim standardima. Mi znamo da je transportna infrastruktura, uključujući železnicu, od ključne važnosti za privredni rast. Tako će ovaj deo Srbije, jugoistočna Srbija, zahvaljujući ovom projektu, privući još više investicija. Znamo da do sada je u ovaj deo Srbije su došle neke od velikih kompanija sa sedištem u Evropskoj uniji, poput Michelina, velikog proizvođača guma, koji je došao u fabriku Tiger Tires u Pirotu. Nakon toga oni su postali šesti po veličini najveći izvoznik iz Srbije u 2023. godini sa izvozom obima 454,9 miliona evra.
And the logistics center of the free zone in Pirot with the railway connection in the future could benefit from increased capacity on the Niš Dimitrovgrad railway line. And of course, furthermore, in these parts of the country, the gas interconnector with Bulgaria that we inaugurated a few months ago can offer to the companies and to the citizens a new source of energy and therefore new opportunities for economic development.
Pored toga, logistički centar u slobodnoj zoni Pirot zajedno sa železničkom vezom će u budućnosti doneti dodatne koristi za veći kapacitet ove železničke deonice Niš-Dimitrovgrad. Mi smo takođe radili i na gasnoj interkonekciji koju smo svečano otvorili ovde pre nekoliko meseci, što zašto veliku korist imaju i građani, ali i privreda.
We're very proud to work with Serbia of this type of project that can provide opportunities for socio-economic development and brings a direct benefit to the country and to the citizens as a whole. This project is part of the 2021 Economic Investment Plan for the Western Balkans that has been launched a few years ago and which aim at leveraging up to 30 billion euros until 2027 for the development in the region. But we started with the Economic Investment Plan and now we're continuing with the Growth Plan and more specific with the upcoming Growth and Reform Facility for the Western Balkans with an additional 6 billion euros for the period 2024 and 2027 for the Western Balkans.
Ponosni smo što možemo da damo svoj doprinos socijalno-ekonomskom razvoju čitave zemlje, ali i šire. Ovaj projekat je deo našeg velikog projekta ekonomsko-investicionog plana za Severni, za Zapadni Balkan, koji je pokrenut pre par godina, kojim se finansiraju veliki infrastrukturni projekti u regionu. Nastavili smo i dalje i sada smo krenuli sa planom rasta Evropske unije, konkretnije sa programom rasta i reforme za Zapadni Balkan, koji će ovom regionu doneti dodatnih 6 milijardi evra kao podrška najvažnijim reformama i privrednom razvoju u periodu od 2024. do 2027.
But that's not enough. The European Union is determined to support in Serbia and all citizens in Serbia in delivering on the country's strategic choice and ambition to become a member of the European Union. And these are not the mere words from the EU ambassador today in Pirot. You might have heard me saying these already before. But I really want to stress the enlargement of the European Union in the Western Balkans is back at the top of the European Union agenda, and we need to accelerate in that context the socio-economic convergence of the region with the European Union. And this is where the Growth Facility, together with the IPA funds of the Economic Investment Plan, will provide a new aid intensity to the region, which is similar to the level of aid intensity provided to member states already benefiting from the cohesion policy.
Naravno, to nije dovoljno. Mi smo rešeni da pružimo pomoć Srbiji u njenom strateškom izboru i ambiciji da postane članica Evropske unije. To naravno nisu samo puke reči od ambasadora Evropske unije danas ovde u Pirotu, za koje ste me čuli da sam izgovorio toliko puta ranije. Sa ovim želim samo da istaknem, da naglasim da je proširenje ka Zapadnom Balkanu ponovo na vrhu agende Evropske unije i želimo da uz da se ekonomski na svaki drugi način Srbija približi Evropskoj uniji. Zato i imamo ovaj program reformi i rasta koji će omogućiti da intenzitet pomoći po glavi stanovnika u Srbiji dostigne onaj nivo kakav imaju same zemlje članice kada govorimo o pomoći koju dobijaju iz kohezionih fondova.
As we support member states in strengthening the prosperity for the citizens, we want to continue and even accelerate to provide support to Serbia and its citizens and make the benefit of membership felt to the citizens even before membership is achieved. And this is the logic of the growth plan for the Western Balkans. The journey of Serbia towards the European Union can accelerate. It's time to board the train. A vala svima, radimo zajedno dalje.